My name is Akil Williams. I am the general manager of provider solutions here at GoodRx. And we want to do a couple of things today. First, we want to give you guys a brief overview of GoodRx, then an overview of provider mode. And then we'll do a demo, and then we'll do Q&A. And if we don't make it fun and interactive, don't worry. We're also sponsoring the Second Line Parade this evening that will take off from Jack's Brewery. So if I'm not as lively as a Second Line Parade, I'll make it up this evening, promise. So myself, again, provider mode and provider solutions general manager. Gracie is our product lead, as well as Shoshana. They're the architects behind GoodRx, and they'll take you through the demos as well as the features and the feature set and things of that nature. So a lot of people ask, why did you create provider mode? And why do you work at GoodRx, and what is your mission here at GoodRx? So as many of you may know, like 3 in 10 patients often don't pick up their medication due to cost. It's too expensive, they're non-adherent, they're non-compliant, right? And also 3% of eligible patients are actually using patient support programs that they're actually eligible for. So there's this huge gap between awareness of the programs and awareness of solutions like GoodRx, like access programs, like patient support programs, and people actually getting on them, right? And then that kind of gap is even further exacerbated by at-risk communities or marginalized communities. So as we get into that, we want to have you all take out your phones. There'll be a ton of QR codes. Even though it's old technology, it made a resounding comeback during the pandemic, and we're going to leverage it a little bit today. So one of the first things we want to ask is, how often do you have cost conversations with patients? Now, I imagine for this group, it will be like 20, 50, 100 times per month, right? So you're already 100%. They're saying 100 times, 10 times per month. But what we ultimately want to do is we want to equip you with better ways to have this cost conversation, right? Because often what we see is it's not an issue that HCPs or other healthcare professionals or providers don't want to have the conversations. They're often not equipped with the tools and the resources and the language to have the conversation. And that's one of the things that we built with Provider Mode. So don't worry, this won't be the last Slido. I will ask for your input multiple times over and over again. And then we'll also have the Q&A at the end. So again, 15% of physicians in a recent survey said that they want to have that affordability conversation, or they're having that affordability conversation with their patients. But 91% actually report that it's actually important to manage patients' out-of-pocket costs. Often physicians tell us in our research when we create a provider mode that, you know, it's frustrating to be able to write a prescription to figure out exactly what the diagnosis is and what the solution is, and then send my patient off to the pharmacy almost, and it's kind of like a guessing game. Are they going to be able to cover it? Is it going to be too expensive? And there's a lot of like anxiety and frustration there, right? So only 1 in 5 doctors, or 21%, can actually accurately estimate out-of-pocket costs. And again, with Provider Mode, we want to help with that. Because here at GoodRx, our main mission, our vision, is really helping Americans get the healthcare they need at a price that they can afford. And what that looks like from what we call the GoodRx effect is that since we've been around for 12 plus years, we've helped fulfill 80 million plus prescriptions that otherwise wouldn't have been fulfilled, which leads to $60 billion in savings on prescription drugs and over $70 million in avoided hospitalizations. So we call it the GoodRx effect. This was V1 of the GoodRx effects research paper that came out early last year. We're working on V2 to take some of these findings and take them even further to see what is the impact of when you can actually reduce affordability or reduce costs and make affordability better for patients and for caregivers. So ultimately, GoodRx is a trusted partner to key stakeholders along the healthcare journey. Whether it's the 25 million patients annually that use GoodRx to save on their prescriptions, or the hundreds of thousands of healthcare providers that use GoodRx in provider mode, we have a high trust score with both groups. And it's also with a lot of our pharma community. We have hundreds of brands that have partnerships on GoodRx that allow their cost savings to be integrated directly into our platform. So not only do you see a GoodRx coupon, which we know are really good. You also see a manufacturer access program. And then what Gracie and Shoshana would talk about is our most recent feature that we unrolled, which is real-time benefit check. So I told you we're going to have more QR codes. I didn't lie. So how often, or how do you most often share GoodRx savings with patients? This is a very assumptive question that you share GoodRx savings with patients, because otherwise we probably wouldn't have 25 million without the community here. So we just are curious of like, what do you generally use to share GoodRx savings with patients? Is it word of mouth? Is it handing out the GoodRx cards that we send to every doctor's office in the country effectively? Is it telling people to text or when you go on the website, texting or emailing the coupon to a patient without like, sharing your personal identifiable information? Or what we actually heard is a lot of providers who aren't super tech savvy like to literally print off the price page and then hand it to a patient. So when that patient shows up at the pharmacy, they can have something in their hand to point to and say, this is the savings I want. This is the price that my caregiver, that my HCP group told me to get. So interesting, word of mouth. So we have our work cut out for us, and we appreciate the word of mouth referrals as well. So with that, that's our overview of GoodRx. I'll hand it off to Gracie to give you guys a walkthrough of provider mode and some of the features and benefits there as well.
So that was great to hear that you all are at least talking about GoodRx, and word of mouth is one of the most predominant ones we have seen. We want to talk about what more you can do with GoodRx, with GoodRx provider mode. We have built it to help providers, to help people like you, help the patients with affordability conversations. Our goal is to empower healthcare professionals to improve affordability of prescription drugs for their patients. We want to empower you with all the information and all the tools that you need so that you can go ahead and have that affordability conversation and even more. So we don't want to just stop there. Before we talk about what you can do with provider mode, let's talk about some of the principles that we keep in mind during a product development process. These are important because that's what brings us closer to you all as the users. First of all, we want to be helpful. We want to make sure that we are delivering value while minimizing additional burden for you. We know you all are super busy, and we do that by taking on complexity on your behalf. We want to provide you the information in the most simple way as possible. We also want to make sure that your experience with provider mode is super efficient. Because you're so busy, how can we reduce the number of clicks? How can we make it as simple and easy to use for you? We also know in healthcare space, trustworthiness is super important. So we want to build and continue maintaining the trust that you all have with GoodRx. And we do that by making sure that we are accurate, reliable, transparent, and also good stewards of your data. And last but not least, we really want to make this the most comprehensive destination for you. We want to have all the savings options for all the prescription types, whether it's brand drugs or generic drugs or specialty drugs. We want to be that one-stop shop for you. So keeping those principles in mind, we really offer three key capabilities for you. One is offering seamless access to drug info, offering a complete picture of costs and savings, and making it super easy to share with patients so that we complete that loop, that patient handoff, and not just be left at having affordability conversations. We'll talk through each of those one by one. So first, seamless access to drug info. As you can see, maybe a little bit hazily, we offer you the most searched drugs right under the search bar so that you don't even have to type a word. You can just click on them and single click go to the drug page. We also offer lowest coupon prices right next to it so that we don't have to leave the homepage if that's what you came in for. Be able to offer you as much as we can on homepage itself. We really pride ourselves in having one of the most complete picture of costs and savings for prescription drugs. We, of course, have GoodRx coupon that lowers out-of-pocket drug costs for a lot of the prescription drugs that we know. We offer you the lowest coupon price across pharmacies in a zip code so that you can choose the pharmacy that's not just close to the patient, but also offers a really good price. But we go over and above that. What happens if GoodRx coupon price is not necessarily reducing the price that much for a drug like Ozempic here? We just last week launched this new feature called Insurance Check that really allows you to check insurance coverage for a prescription drug for a patient so that you don't have to wait for the patient to reach the pharmacy and tell you whether that drug was covered by the insurance or not. This was one of the top pain points that we heard from our providers and is one of the reasons why providers don't have those cost conversations with patients that Akhil was talking about. And all you have to do is really just enter patient information. You have to enter name, first name, last name, date of birth, gender, and zip code. So no insurance card details required. And you get back detailed insurance coverage information, such as whether it is covered by the insurance or not, what their copay is, keeping in mind the deductible, whether a prior authorization is required or not. So all of that information available on GoodRx using a simple account. And for this particular feature, you do have to do an NPI verification, but rest of the entire experience doesn't require any NPI. Next, we go over and beyond that. We really want to make sure we offer a wide suite of manufacturer copay cards and patient support forms for hub enrollment and patient assistance programs. So no more like trying to find the right manufacturer website or the right drug website and trying to find the correct form there. You can have all in one place here. And I know it's a little bit hard to see in the screenshots here. Shoshana will be walking through all of it in a demo. So everything should come into life. We just want to make sure you have a good idea of what we're going to be talking about in the demo. And what happens if one of those cost-saving options doesn't actually work for the patient? We also offer cost comparison of alternative drugs within the same class so that maybe there is a cheaper drug out there that may work better for the patient if the savings options do not work out. So that's all about offering the most comprehensive picture that we can of the costs and savings of prescription drugs. But we don't want you to have to leave the patient empty-handed after you've had that cost conversation with the patient. We want to make sure you're able to actually give them something for them to take back with. So you all, obviously, I saw in the survey, some of you use text or email the coupon. Some of you use the print as well. One thing to note, if you don't already know, is that any of these methods don't share any personal contact details. So you don't share your phone number or your email address. Everything comes directly from GoodRx. So it's a nice way to be able to share without worrying about somebody calling you or emailing you. This is a brand new feature that we launched recently as well, QR code again, to really be able to share the entire price page with your patient. You won't have to even type in any information for that. You can just expand the QR code, turn over the screen, and have the person scan the QR code, and you're like good to go. So that's like another way we are constantly thinking about how do we make it as easy and efficient as possible for you. Cool, so that was the entire summary of what Provider Mode, GoodRx Provider Mode has to offer to you. Before I hand over for the demo where everything will come to life for you, I wanted to read this quote out, which I read from one of the users, and it really is very, very inspiring. So nothing has changed prescribing like GoodRx has. They don't teach us in residency that you can prescribe all day long, but if you can't access them or afford them, there's really no point. And this touched me so much because I know like we are making a change in the world, and I'm excited for what we can do, all of us together. So now I'll hand off to Shoshana for the demo.
All right. I don't need that, actually.
Oh, yes.
Thank you, Gracie. All right, advocates, thank you so much. Thank you, Akhil and Gracie, for that wonderful overview. So once we explain to people what there is to do in Provider Mode, the number one question we get is, how can I get in? How can I get into Provider Mode? Do I need an MPI? I know all of you in this room are advocates in your own right. You all hold individually unique roles in the healthcare ecosystem. So I want to invite all of you. I know your phones are out or your laptops. I see them right there. Join me in Provider Mode right now for a quick demo so you can see just how easy it is to actually use Provider Mode in your day-to-day work with your patients. You can scan that code. There's also pamphlets on the table, or if you're on a laptop, as I see some of them, you could go to goodrx.com/provider/join. Now, we don't require any personal information. It's free to use. All you have to do is select the role that best represents what you do in the workplace, and then you can join me and get started in exploring how you can use Provider Mode to help improve patient outcomes. So I'll give you a few seconds to do that and join me in Provider Mode right then and there. If you want to add your email address to create an account, we can stay in touch with you. You can personalize your experience. Feel free, but feel free to skip that as well. All right, so what you'll notice right off the bat, like Gracie already showed, is that you land on your Provider Mode homepage. Now, here on your homepage, the more you search, the more customized the experience becomes. As you'll see at the top of the page, we have your most commonly searched drugs. So you don't have to keep typing in the same things over and over again for the drugs that you're most often prescribing or you're seeing most often in your office. You'll see here that we're also showing you the lowest coupon prices for GoodRx. So if you're on your lunch break, you're in between patients, you just want to do that quick gut check about where GoodRx coupon prices are trending, just hit your homepage, look at your most popular search drugs, find those prices right away. But now I want to walk you through a super common scenario, right? A patient comes up to you, let's call her Jessica in this case, and she just got prescribed atorvastatin for the first time. Now, it's always scary when you get prescribed a new drug. It's a new healthcare journey for yourself. You're not sure how you're going to pay for it or how much it's going to cost. With single-click navigation right here, we'll head over to the atorvastatin drug page. So you're sitting with Jessica, and she asks you, how can I afford this drug? What are my options? So right here on the price page, you'll notice a couple of things. Local pharmacy prices right at the top. You can speak to Jessica, figure out her preferred pharmacy, and find that coupon for her within a matter of seconds. Even better, you can look at the rest of the pharmacies. If you expand the show six pharmacies below, you might actually be able to find Jessica a cheaper price than at the pharmacy she normally goes to. And therefore, you can find the coupon that will work best for her. When you click get free savings right there on the side, you can open up that coupon and easily share it with Jessica in just a matter of clicks, depending on what her preference is. You can text it, you can email it. It doesn't share your personal information. And for those that are a little bit less tech savvy or want something tangible in their hands, we understand. Print the coupon and hand it to them, and they can walk it straight to the pharmacy. That's all they need to get the prescription prices that we're offering on GoodRx. If you go back to the atorvastatin page, in addition to pricing, we also provide other patient education and support. You get a new prescription and you probably have tons of questions. Dosing, interactions, side effects. We have peer-reviewed health information written by our GoodRx clinicians. It's super easy to share with your patients so that they can continue on their learning journey after they leave your office. As we mentioned with QR codes, we want to make sure that this information moves with the patient when they leave the room. So you can easily expand or print this QR code to transplant the GoodRx price page onto their own device. No more wondering if Jessica's going to remember how to type in atorvastatin or if she's going to remember her drug configuration correctly. She can walk away with exactly what she needs to make the best decision for her when she leaves the room. Now, it looks like most of you in this room are familiar with GoodRx. You've been on GoodRx, you've shared it, and historically, we've been known for having the best coupon prices for generic drugs. But what a lot of people don't realize is that we are also a hub for brand drugs. We have thousands of brand drugs on our site, and as Akhil mentioned, hundreds of savings opportunities surface for brand drugs. So I want to take you on a little brand drug journey, all right? Ozempic is a drug that's a hot topic right now. I'm sure all of you have talked about it with patients in one way or another. They want to know how they can get on it. They want to know if their insurance covers. So let's go to the Ozempic price page. What you'll notice first is that there's multiple ways to pay for Ozempic. And since our goal here at GoodRx is to surface all of the information that you need to help a patient make the right decision, we surface all of those options right at the top of the page. You'll notice a copay card, which is a manufacturer discount. You'll notice the newfound super powerful ability to check insurance coverage in real time with your patient, and you'll notice the GoodRx coupon. Now, in this case, with Ozempic, the GoodRx coupon is still a bit pricey, right? So you'll probably pay attention to a couple of the other options. If you click on Get Details on the copay card, you're able to read about copay card eligibility and discuss with your patient if this is the right move for them. In addition to that, I want to talk about RTBC, real-time benefits check. This was a feature that was just launched last week. It is extremely unique and extremely powerful here on GoodRx, which empowers you to actually have a full cohesive visual of all savings options. With a free account and a valid prescriber NPI, you can unlock really, really valuable information for that patient about their insurance coverage. Like Gracie mentioned, is it covered by insurance? What kind of copay can I expect when I get to the pharmacy? Is prior authorization required? Most of the time, patients have no idea about this by the time they get to the pharmacy. I've seen it time and time again. They ask the pharmacist to readjudicate based on insurance. Then they ask the pharmacist to run GoodRx. Then they want to go back to insurance because it was actually cheaper. And everyone's pretty frustrated. And so this feature was really the number one feature asked by healthcare professionals and advocates alike, and we delivered. Now, in addition to helping get savings to patients, what's super unique about GoodRx is that we are actually in the exam room with the prescriber when they're making prescribing decisions. Our data shows it. Our prescribers, our advocates are on GoodRx for hours in the middle of the day, which means they're sitting there with their EHR, with GoodRx, with a patient having these conversations. And that enables us as a company and as a product to bring you prescribing tools even before the prescribing decision has been made. So we're going to go to the search bar at the top. If you're on mobile, it's on the top right of your screen. And we're going to search for Xarelto, another brand drug. When you get to that page, you'll notice that Xarelto is a brand drug, still pretty pricey, right? If you scroll down to the middle of the page, something that we bring you uniquely in provider mode is the ability to compare drugs in the same class. And this gives the prescriber a full visual of the options that they can prescribe in order to treat a given condition. So that means that they have all the information to potentially stay the course with the given brand drug, maybe switch to a different brand drug that might be more affordable, or potentially find a generic alternative, which will most likely be the most affordable option for their patient in that given moment. And so this is really powerful by putting all of the information the prescriber needs at their hands in that given moment of prescribing. Now, all of us in the room who are advocates in one way or another know just how burdensome healthcare paperwork can be, right? So you decide that a person needs to be on a brand or specialty drug, but there's specialty hub enrollment, there's patient assistance programs you need to apply for. Instead of scouring the internet and going to multiple manufacturer sites or other websites, we know you're on GoodRx looking for pricing. We want to give you those forms right at your fingertips. And so at the top of the page, you'll notice our patient support forms feature, which we've launched in partnership with Rx Lightning, who is here today. With a couple of simple clicks, you can reach here. We'll get started. We'll show you in real time actually how quick it can be. Select which forms you want. In this case, we'll do a joint hub and PAP form. Click get form, and in a matter of seconds, we will actually pull that PDF form straight to your fingertips. You can download it, you can print it, you can share it with a colleague. Get started on getting your patient access to that drug right then and there. Don't delay the paperwork. So all in all, we've heard what advocates and prescribers need to help patients get on treatment and stay on treatment. It's not just about making the right prescribing decision, it's about getting them the savings methods they need so they can adhere to their treatment, so they can have better patient outcomes, which as advocates is what all of us want at the end of the day. It's why we're all here. So thank you so much for diving in with me into this live demo. We have another quick Slido question. Now that you've heard what provider mode is all about and you've seen what we're able to do, we are curious to hear from you all. What features do you think you would use most in provider mode? Think about your day-to-day interactions with patients. Scan it on the screen and let us know. Is it checking insurance prices, finding copay card programs, sharing savings directly with patients? Is it comparing alternatives, picking a pharmacy, or even downloading forms? We want to hear, we're getting a lot of love for checking insurance prices, finding copay cards. All right, let's let them flow through a little bit. Nice, nice, nice. Yeah, checking insurance prices is really, really powerful, especially because we don't require any recitation of these long insurance ID numbers, H1, JK, LMNOP. I mean, no one's ever going to type that in correctly. Awesome. This is really cool. So we can go to the last slide here. This is the Advocate Summit. You know, we're all here because we care about patient outcomes, and GoodRx was built on the mission to get patients on treatment that they can afford and that they can stay on. And all of you as advocates, you know, we're here to support you in supporting patients in getting the help that they need, whether it's talking to patients about costs, actually using print, text, email, QR to share savings with patients, or even just spreading awareness that this cost conversation is crucial. Each one of you in the audience and all of us at GoodRx, in partnership with you, we have the power to transform lives one prescription at a time. We're excited to continue on this journey in doing this alongside all of you. We hope you'll join us in provider mode as users, free users, explore, give us feedback, talk to us. We want to know, we want to hear. So thank you so much for joining us. And we're going to open it up to Q&A. You all have helped us so much. We want to, we have some fun prizes for those bold souls that might want to ask a question about GoodRx or about provider mode. So we're going to give you all a couple seconds to brainstorm and open it up to Q&A. Thank you so much for joining us.
And I think each question asker gets a gift. Kind of cool. So back in the corner. They're good gifts, I hear.
They are.
Are we asking for here?
Oh, Mike is in the center. My bad.
There we go.
My bad.
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Art Singer. I'm been a healthcare advocate for about 42 years. It'll be 43 this year. In various forms. Thank you. I actually got a real designation just last year. I'm a retired adjunct professor of insurance at the UCLA School of Public Health. And I say that in advance because I want to avoid giving anybody the impression that I'm trying to be confrontational. I am really, really not. The first thing I want to ask is, I noticed that the full, and by the way, I'm an advocate of GoodRx. I use it in my practice all the time. But the provider mode requires an NPI number, correct?
No. So that's something we also wanted to clear up as well. Provider mode does not require an NPI. Any healthcare professional in the office, whether prescriber or not, has access to the platform. What requires an NPI is to unlock the real-time insurance check.
Okay, so you can register for the provider mode without having an NPI number.
Correct.
Yes.
Okay, but the insurance check, okay. All right, I think I get it. Your collateral material is just a little bit confusing.
A little misleading. Okay, yeah. Thanks for clarifying that on behalf of the audience. Yeah.
Then knowing that, if somehow or another I was to able to access an NPI number or I had a client, physician client who could use it, how often is the insurance data uploaded? And also the other question is does that include Part D plans?
So that's a good question. I think we partnered with the real-time benefit check with AssistRx with their iAssist platform. So it's very similar or 100% similar to the capabilities that iAssist has. It updates daily, if not more often than that, by loading almost 80% of patient lives in the U.S. and kind of pinging their network. I think that answers your question.
Well, I was talking about plan specific plans of insurance.
Yep, it will be updated and have the data for Part D as well.
Daily. Yeah. And Part D plans.
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm an independent healthcare advocate, and it was a great presentation. I think one of the misconceptions that people have, though, is that we can, as advocates, can check the insurance benefits, and that would be really, really helpful for us because I don't think the doctors are going to be doing it. So that's my personal opinion. It would be really helpful if we, as advocates, could check that for our clients.
Yeah, that's great feedback. I completely agree. Thank you for that suggestion.
Yeah.
Okay, I had a similar question with the NPIs. As an allied health professional, but not a doctor, nurse, et cetera, I can't get an NPI. Does it save the individual NPI in the system as I'm doing it, or do I enter it each time in case
it's like Facebook.
Doctors?
Once you log in, you're logged in until you logged out. Right.
Okay. You only have to add the verified NPI to
the first time you create
and
the
then,
account.
And then it won't prompt you for it again on your continuous
check. Okay,
what
if I'm working with multiple doctors with multiple NPIs?
On the register. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You, if you desired, you have the ability to change to a different verified MPI, but it won't prompt you to change that unless you desire to change the MPI on the account.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Hi. So this is a great presentation. I am a pharmacist. I have an NPI number. So my first question is, are pharmacist NPIs recognized by the platform?
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. Okay. Second question I have for you is about the real-time insurance checks.
Yes.
How are we doing that if you don't require insurance information? I guess
so
I'm
it's,
a little hazy
yeah, pretty,
on how that happens.
It's magic.
Pretty cool. So it's so patient's first name, last name, date of birth, and gender is all that's required to check the benefit.
But this is a specific check, though, right?
It's a specific check. That... It's not an estimate. It's right. not a guesstimate. It's a specific check for that
so
individual patient.
For that as well. So what happens in back end is, first the patient information is sent to do an eligibility check with all the possible payers, and then once we know which payers have it, then the actual insurance check is done.
Okay, very good. That was my question.
And here comes your prize.
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
One last question about the platform.
You only get one prize, even though
it's she's trying to double them up.
I was hustling. The other question I have about the platform is, does it currently have the capability of EHR integration? Any component in parts or fully?
None currently.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I am super excited for this opportunity to use this platform. I do work with self-insured employers, and we know that they can be very convoluted and complex, especially the providers and the payer accelerators or the accumulators and some of the other programs that they have. So I wanted to know, how sophisticated is that? Does it identify those companies that have them? And because
So when you do the real-time benefit check, it'll tell whether or not the patient is eligible for a copay card. It does have the capability to say how far along are they towards their copay and things of that nature. It's not built in V1. That's just 7 days out. Currently, it'll tell you their price on their coverage, copay card eligibility, and prior auth. That's all, you know, V1. But V2, we should put you on the product team. Because
thank you. I'm hoping that that's going to...
Thank you.
Hi. Yeah, this could be a really stupid question, but I'm just really excited, first of all, you know, your product, and I wanted to, you know, follow your instruction, but in my iPhone, it seems a little different, and I don't even, like, get question to, you know, check the insurance price.
You have to make sure you do goodrx.com/provider/join.
Yeah, we'll be over here after the session, and we can help walk you through. Yeah.
Happy to help, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Happy to help you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I got one question, the hard question. How do you get paid?
That's a good question.
Yeah, it's not
we planted
hard.
You an audience,
like,
right?
I prepared like I was taking the SAT for this question. And I don't even know the answer anymore. The bright lights are blinding me. No, GoodRx works similar to, like, I don't know, like a Travelocity when you book a flight on Travelocity. When a patient or a consumer uses a coupon for a prescription, we get a referral fee. So
from the pharmacy?
From the PBM that powers the pricing that you see in all the pages. Okay. Yeah.
But we're not making money off of provider mode in that way, so it's free to use.
Yeah, provider mode's free to use.
Yeah.
So a real quick question, how are you bypassing with this? Because you're not the actual pharmacy that's filling it from the referral of the script. How are you doing the verification of benefit live with that without HIPAA consent from the patient to do that?
Are you talking about in the real-time benefit
check?
So that's, yeah, so that's all managed through the iAssist platform, not in GoodRx. So they effectively pipe all of that kind of compliance in, yeah.
But for that healthcare provider, they're obligated to share and get HIPAA consent from patients before they resource any third party for information on that patient's benefits, which they're doing that here.
Well, it's not a third party because they're not coming. It doesn't come back to us. It's just between them and their provider. iAssist effectively is an EHR, so it's not, nothing comes out and comes back to GoodRx.
And a BA agreement is signed during the verification process between the healthcare provider and AssistRx.
Right. Mm-hmm.
We didn't show you the whole flow, but there's just a couple simple slides to go through.
We had to put an NPI.
It's accounted for.
Yes.